Hi, and welcome back to Penelope and Company. My name is Devine. I am your official soap maker for today. Thank you very much for stopping by. I really, really do appreciate it. I hope you like the video. Today we have scheduled a black, raspberry, and vanilla soap. This is a restock. I do make this every year, actually a couple of times throughout the year, just because it's a really good seller. Everybody loves it, and it's an amazing fragrance. We've got our embeds, and we've got all of our colors and glitter and everything that I have prepared for today's soap. So I hope you like it, and we're gonna get soaping, okay? Okay, so today we're gonna go ahead and make, we're gonna restock, I should say, and make black, raspberry, and vanilla. We've got all of our base oils here. We've got our sodium hydroxide, which is also our lye water here. And we will mix the two together. And I'm gonna go ahead and blend those. And then we'll get color in and all that other fun stuff. Okay. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and section this off into 1, 2, 3 buckets. Okay, so we have everything sectioned off. We're gonna go ahead and add our colors. And then this one right here is gonna go ahead and have titanium dioxide in it, which I'm gonna go ahead and mix later. But I have that pre-mixed with water in this little cup. So we'll go ahead and start with this one. And then I'm going to add the fragrance to these two. This is actually the end of this bottle, so I know what the pre-measured amount already is that's in there. All right, so that is done. I'm gonna go ahead and mix this in by hand using the spatula. Sometimes if you use a stick blender when adding the fragrance, it accelerates the soap so much to where you can't even use it. But of course that always depends upon the blend of the fragrance. And this fragrance actually performs really, really well. That's the reason why I like it. I don't have any problems with it. I never have had problems with it. I soap very low and also with a water discount. Like I said, I've just never had any problems with it. This would be a really good beginner fragrance to use if you've never soaked before. I absolutely love it, and it smells divine. It smells absolutely amazing. Okay, so we'll put that off to the side. We'll do the same to this one. I'm trying to get out every last little bit. Okay, we're done with that one. So we'll mix this. One thing I like about mixing the fragrance oils in by hand, you really get to see if there's any mica on the bottom or anywhere in between hiding that's gonna mess with your soap later. I mean, look at this. This is awesome. I love it. Makes for a beautiful swirl too. So I have these little curly things that I use every single time that I make this particular soap, and I'm gonna put it in to the batter. I might put it in the batter and mix it up, or I might just sprinkle it on in between layers or something. I don't know what I'm gonna do, but anyways, this also is black raspberry vanilla, and it smells, I could just rub it all over myself because, well, I guess that's what you do with soap, but it smells absolutely, absolutely amazing. I can't get over how well it smells. So we'll add that to this. And then I have some, we'll make our icing or topping. And then we will, for our piping, and then we will probably sprinkle some more of that on there. I don't know what we'll do. We'll figure it out as we go. All right, so I'm gonna put that up to the side. Let's get our mold. Voila! We have our mold. Okay, so we have our mold here. I'm gonna go ahead and just start pouring in the colors. We'll probably do a couple of passes for each one, and we'll go from there. I am probably gonna pour in about half of the purple.
And then I'm going to pour in the red or the raspberry color in up high. And we'll do a couple of those passes. Then I'll do some white. And then come back with the purple. Sorry if the bucket's in your face. All right, so now we're gonna come back in with the pink. I'm trying to get it in the corners. Kind of so it gets everywhere. All right. Come back in with the white. And then we'll scrape our buckets. I'm gonna go ahead and swirl this, and then I'm gonna go ahead and the little shavings that we have, I'm gonna go ahead and sprinkle that on top of here. And then we will go ahead and do our piping so we can get this on here, okay? All right, so, oh, amazing. So I'm just gonna kind of sprinkle this all along. Okay, so I went ahead and I sprinkled on all of the little shavings, and we've mixed that in here, and I'm gonna go ahead and set this aside, make the piping, and we will be right back. Okay, so I have taken a little bit of the piping, and I want to kind of make a division of a line right here between the two. And I took a portion of the color that I did not scrape out. I left a little bit on the side just so I can kind of incorporate it and kind of add some a little bit of interest. Just taking this and kind of spreading it back and forth just so there's a little bit of white. Okay, so we have that done, and I'm gonna put this off to the side and come back, and we'll go ahead and pipe the top. Okay, so we are back, and we're gonna go ahead and start piping this. We're gonna go ahead and do three dollops across. We're using the circle tip. I don't know why, but I absolutely love this tip. I just think it makes it look so edible. When I, whatever it is that I make, it's, I love it. And I'm also more partial to the sweet fragrances. I don't know, maybe because I have such a sweet tooth. You can start to see the color coming out of it, out of the piping bag. All right, so we'll start back down here at the top. Oh my gosh, this is so pretty. I love it. It smells so good. Wish I could. I don't know, I could eat it all. All right, well, that will be a special bar. Yay, we got every last little bit out of there. Awesome. So we're gonna go ahead and add our embeds and our glitter and all of our fun stuff to this. So give me 1 second, let me go grab this. Okay, so we have, can you see those? Oh yeah, there you go. We have all of our blackberries that we went ahead and made. And then I have our glitters. So we'll go ahead and put one of these on each bar of soap. And I make sure that my lines were all straight. So we don't want to chop a blackberry in half or anything. Okay, now that we have that on there, we're going to go ahead and add Paris Pink glitter on. We're gonna go ahead and do it on both sides. This is so fine that it just comes literally pouring out. All right, and then we're gonna go ahead and use the white diamond from TKB Trading. This is a little bit thicker. Come on. And I also need to fill up my container because we're kind of out. It's coming out. It's taking its sweet time. But we've got that on there. Okay, and then I've also mixed up some of the firecracker red mica with oil that I'm going to go ahead and put on here. I purposely mixed this in the titanium dioxide container because I wanted a little bit of the white flakes to show through. So I'm just going to kind of drizzle it on here and there. I like how it falls like down the soap. And then we'll do it on this side too. Kind of just goes in the cracks. I don't know, I like the way it looks. We're gonna add just a little bit more glitter. But we'll do shimmer or pearl this time. Boy, this is covered. Okay, so this is our black raspberry and vanilla, and you can almost see it flying in the air. That's so neat. Okay, well, we will be back 18 to 24 hours later to go ahead and cut the soap, and we will see you then. Thanks, bye. Oh my God, all of that didn't record. I am so sorry. Well, I've cut the soap. I've shown you a couple of pieces. My bad. I'm so sorry. But here we go. This kind of looks like a genie right here to me, at least. It smells amazing. The fragrance always stands out, and I love it even more when you can smell the fragrance, especially again right after you cut it. It's like the aroma just comes out all over again, and I just think it just smells awesome. This is a staple in our shop. Whenever anybody comes in, they definitely can smell it, that's for sure. We do sell out of this very quickly. It's just because it's a really good fragrance. And everybody, I haven't shown you the top. Oh, well, and then, of course, that's the one that has the boo-boo. It was cut in half, so let's show you a better one. Maybe I'll just keep that one. Okay. So, yes, we do sell out of this one quite often. I should probably make it more than I normally do. I love all the glitter. Yay. I should probably make it more than I do just because we sell out so quickly, so often. So, but we'll see. I don't know. I don't like to really make the same thing too much. I want to keep it, just kind of keep a variety of different fragrances and not always have the same staples. But I do make this in a few of our other staples at least once a year. So there we go. There you go. I love it when you find shapes in the soaps from pouring it. Anyways, I hope you guys have a wonderful day. We will be back with another soap. And don't forget to subscribe and then also follow us on any other social media that we have. See you soon. Bye-bye.